following is a presentation of TFNN. Time to talk about your health. Living a primal lifestyle.
We have Mike from Chicago on the line, and he has a question about digestion.
Hi, Mike.
Hey, guys. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
First of all, I just wanted to say that I love the show. I think it's great programming, and I'm very much of a like mind when it comes to, you know, taking control of your own health and certainly doing your own research.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now your hosts, Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark.
Happy Friday and welcome to Living a Primal Lifestyle, where Paige and I explore a return to a more balanced, natural, wild world to take back control of our personal choices as well as our health and freedom. I'm Nico DeHaan.
And I'm Paige Clark.
And it's a beautiful day here in downtown Clearwater. It's about 85 degrees. The sun is out. Might have a shower or two this weekend, but we're loving life here in Florida, that's mm-hmm. for sure. Please subscribe to our Health Signals newsletter, and please pick up some Primal Edge so you can be healthy and feel really good about yourself. And you can do this on the TFNN.com website. And we are also taking your phone calls at 877-927-6648. So I'd like to start, first of all, by saying condolences to you and your family because your father passed away.
Yes.
I'm so sorry.
Thanks, Nico.
I know.
It's tough.
It's very tough.
Tough week.
Yeah, and it's something that every one of us just about goes through.
Mm-hmm.
And my dad died in the early 90s mm-hmm. of prostate cancer. Mm-hmm. My mother lived in her 90s, was very healthy when she had when she passed away. But, you know, there was cancer in my family. My sister had it, my mother had it, my father had it. So far, I haven't. What was with your dad? Is he healthy all the way through?
Well, no, but he had done some really nice improvements, and I think overall, you know, he had pretty much collected all of those chronic disease diagnoses.
Yeah,
a lot of damage done earlier in his life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he had had heart disease, he had had a bypass, he had diabetes, and he had kidney failure. But in this last year, he had finally, you know, you're never a prophet in your own home.
Yeah,
but he had actually come to me. It's tough because he lost his life partner about 4 months ago.
Oh, boy.
And he looked at me and said, I think you might be onto something here. I want to do what you're doing.
Really?
And, you know, not what I did, but what he did by implementing, he started taking the Primal Edge. He was doing a lot of other nutritional protocols. He went from being what his wound care center thought he was going to be an amputee due to diabetes. He had developed a sore when he had bypass on his legs and caught MRSA in the hospital. And they were all very impressed with the turnaround he had. In fact, at one point, due to the illness from the infection, he was using a walker, and he went from a walker to a cane to nothing, to really having another zest for life and and getting active. But we had some kind of very strange turn in the last 2 to 3 weeks, and that's something that I've been racking my brains the last few days is trying to figure out, you know, what happened. There was something going on with his fluid levels and his electrolytes. Looks like the doctors had him on a couple different fluid pills that I'm thinking maybe was too much, dehydrated him. He had a lot drop of blood pressure, but we did lose him, it appears, in a very peaceful way in his recliner, like he was sleeping. And he did take a bad fall Sunday night, and that had us concerned, but you know, he seemed to have recovered fine from that. And again, that got us onto the idea that there was some blood pressure issues and fluid balance, and we believe that it just went so low and kind of shut things off. So thank you, and it is a tough time, so remember there's not always another day or not tomorrow. Grab them today, pick up that phone or get on that plane, and you know, you don't get to always get to replay.
No, you don't. And you know, people who are estranged from their folks, I think it's very difficult. You know, I think family is a very, very important part of our history as human beings.
Because we stayed
in family groups probably exclusively until maybe just last couple hundred years where we really diverged from that. And, you know, I moved away from my parents and moved far away for a while and got closer to them again. It's a strange thing that we have here that we're, you know, getting away from the people we love.
It is strange and it's sad. And, yeah. You know, the best things in life, Nico, are not things.
That's true.
And it's these times spent with people that we love.
That's true.
And, you know, anybody who has you know, I'm very fortunate that we have one of those families where I feel we have a little saying, love multiplies, it doesn't divide. In other words, you know, in this world of split families and new in-laws and stuff, people, you know, we call them love people. We just multiply and we get along that way. And just don't let a night happen that you're mad at someone. It's just not worth it. It's, you know, we talk so much about the true causes of disease or being at ease, diseased, and to become at ease is to be at peace and to be in love, you know, with all the people that are important to you, and to clear those blocks, and because anything that you haven't cleared can manifest in your body, and that's not, and it's something that I think if you were having a problem with a loved one and they were taken from you early, you would regret not having that opportunity to clear the air. I feel like we were all in good, but you still beat yourself up, you know, like, I wish I'd have done this. I could have done this.
Yeah.
And
my fondest memories of my folks were always when we went away together, went fishing up in Canada, those types of things. And that's another thing I wanted to talk about today was the outdoors.
Yeah.
Because my fondest memory is not only spending it with my dad and my mother and my sister and extended family too, cousins and things like that. And this year I had the opportunity to see my cousins and one of my uncles and one of my aunts. And it's a special feeling that you have when you're with those people. But also, I remember most of those things that I really valued was when we were spending time outside. And there's quite a few studies that tell you that there's, you know, benefits from being outside, not only physical but mental benefits, right?
Exactly. We came across an article in a healthblog.com that says a scientific review has carried out an analysis of existing research, and they've come to the conclusion that there are benefits to it from being in a natural environment, and that's exercising and just being in that outdoor environment. And they analyzed data from various sources, and it included actual randomized and non-randomized controlled studies using close to 1,000 individuals. But I think, like you said, we intuitively just know it feels right.
Yeah, because all my great memories... All my great memories were always when I went on vacation, when I went to Death Valley and spent a week there, or when I went up to the Great North and went to Alaska and saw those things. So all my endearing memories are not only with the people I really care about, but also those times when I spent a lot of time outside in the wild. And it's just everything is better because I remember when I sleep outside, I sleep much better.
You know, I really truly believe that the animals know what to do. By laying on raw ground, they're absorbing all those negative ions, electrons. The electrons are what produce healing in the body. And, you know, as we were saying, it's not just the mental improvement in your health that these studies saw, but the natural environment exercise activity. It was linked to increased energy.
Yeah.
Okay. Greater feelings of revitalization and renewal. Yeah. And the positive engagement, you know, it showed signs of decreasing confusion, tension, depression, anger. I used to have a T-shirt that I liked that said, be an outsider.
Yeah,
you know, not be an insider or insider trading or whatever.
Yeah, be an outsider.
Be an outsider. So be an outsider, guys, this weekend.
Yeah, if you're going to plan some activities, weekends are great to go outside. If you're planning some activities as far as exercising, outside is great. And these days we do have a lot of things that we can do outside, you know, the biking, the running, walking. There's all kinds of little parks around our area where you can go. And
Lucky because of the weather, aren't we?
Yes.
Yes, yeah, and I know some of you guys might be challenged with that. And, we're certainly not, discrediting exercise, whether it be in your gym or in your own home, but remember that connection to the magnetic center of the earth. If you think of your feet as having a connection to the core of the earth, you can understand why connecting via the outside is so important.
Yeah.
Because you're going to get that, you know, through the natural substance of Earth. So we like to say, you know, get outside too.
Yeah, and outside is, you know, what we want, because in jiu-jitsu, you know, when I first went to jiu-jitsu, we had a warehouse that had two huge overhang doors. Mm-hmm. So the first thing that you do when you walk in, you open those doors up, no matter what the weather, 100 degrees or 40 degrees or even
fresh air.
Fresh air. We needed that fresh air. And, you know, we're in a newer dojo now, and we can open the doors when it gets cooler. But when it's hot out, it's really rough in there, because what happens is, of course, we get cool air from the AC, but we lose oxygen. Mm-hmm. Because so many guys are out there huffing and puffing, and, you know, we're doing strenuous exercise, and the oxygen just gets depleted in there. So even if it's 100 degrees out, we'll open that door after a while and say, you know, we need this air. So
yeah, you need that full air.
And it's fresh air.
Yeah,
it's not recycled air. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so.
I can imagine. You know, talking about being outside and being connected and having a good balance because you are connected to the earth, all of these things are showing that they... you know, they're very important for ideal health. And, you know, at the core of ideal health is ideal weight.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're always finding ways to, we talk a lot about here, that we know that ideal physiology is usually accomplished by being at your ideal weight, that excess fat not only slows us down, but has a lot of metabolic processes that include increased storage of toxins and age-related factors. Came across an article in LA Times, longer fasts might help with weight loss, but Americans eat all day long.
Well, we do. There's no doubt about that. And it's hard to switch anybody over from that. I tell people I usually eat twice a day at 6 and 6. And they go, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what happens in between? I don't get hungry. Mm-hmm. Because I'm satisfied with mm-hmm. what I'm eating.
I think this is becoming really at the heart of achieving ideal physiology, is learning to mimic how we might have been prior to times when foods were so plentiful for us. We stimulate our survival genes that that create more of an ideal physiology and therefore resistance to disease.
Yeah.
And that you and I both are big fans. You know, I want to preface before I say this, you know, we're not saying that there's only one way to do this, guys. There's a lot of different ways.
Yeah.
And we're all for experimenting and trying things and seeing what works best for you. But we both agree that increasing our periods of intermittent fasting and feasting, think of the, you know, time you sleep till when you wake up, and perhaps skipping that breakfast meal and incorporating your, shortening that window of which you have lunch and dinner. Yeah. Like you said, you know, you perhaps like to have breakfast at 6 in the morning, and you create a fast period.
Yeah.
Not having really lunch
into
dinner.
It's easier for me that way. Yeah.
There's some new research I saw last week about skipping.
There's a lot of ways of doing it.
Yeah, there's another way of doing it, skipping your dinner and having your breakfast and lunch. But anyways, we got to take a fast break. So hang out with us. Give us a call.
Yep.
Let us answer your questions, and we'll be right back.
877-927-6648. And pick up some Primal Edge during the break, please. You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Nico and Paige take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back to the show, folks. Paige and I here on Living a Primal Lifestyle. You know, Paige, you were talking earlier about bed sores and things like that. And I was wondering, because I've been studying the far infrared heat lamps. Mm-hmm. And in fact, I ordered one. I have one on the Telestrator right now. This one's only $35 on
You said far infrared. Are you saying near?
Near. Excuse me.
Okay, this is near infrared. We have to realize is there's a whole spectrum of light, and folks, if you really want to understand, you know, where we're at, is we only see, you know, if it's a foot long, we see
1 inch maybe.
Yeah, maybe 1 inch of the visible light spectrum, but it is the near and far infrared radiation that has extreme healing potential for our bodies.
The way I understand, the far infrared penetrates about an inch into your body, where the near infrared goes into your organs and everything. It penetrates much deeper into that, maybe as far as 3 inches.
Up to six inches. Yeah, so you know, really, when you stop and think about it, that someone like me, right mm-hmm. now anyways, that could be almost the whole width, see?
Yeah. Well, you just have to turn over,
flip over
a few times.
Except some parts.
The reason I was doing this, because first of all, I'm always concerned about my health, and I know the benefits of this, and I have a nice infrared pad that I lay on, and my wife uses that every night before she goes to bed. And I thought, well, you know, it'd be nice to get a sauna. Mm-hmm. So I'm pricing saunas, and here, you know, we're talking $2,000, $3,000, and I'm thinking, maybe there's an easier way, so just let me dig into some of this stuff that Dr. Wilson always talks about.
Right.
And you've talked about Dr. Wilson.
Dr. Larry Wilson. He is a very interesting, brilliant person.
So I went to his website, and one of the things that popped out was this little lamp here, and I ordered one. It's only $35 plus shipping. So I figured this would be great for my wife, or she has problems with arthritis in her hands.
The red spectrum.
Yeah. And I thought, well, I want to test it out, see how it feels. And then, of course, he takes me to another site that has four lamps, and you can just hang these things in, maybe your bathtub or your shower, or make a little in your room in the closet, that type of thing. And then you're only spending a few $100.
Yeah, there's a picture of this you were sharing with us that shows it actually where someone is using the lounge capability of their bathtub, and they're hanging a quad configuration of these lamps, like right there. I don't know if Al could quick jump on that. We're finding it. There you go.
Right there.
Hanging this quad pack up off of the shower. And, you know, my first reaction is hanging an electrical thing while you're laying in the tub. What if someone accidentally forgot to turn the water on? Not so, but you know. I mean, again, but there's other ways you can, you know, the idea of making it be portable is very nice. You know, there's a lot of people that don't like a fixed wood sauna for numerous reasons, sharing it with other people, kind of feeling confined. I could see where you could get a very heavy shower curtain and create that to be, you know, close it and create more
heat. You don't want a plastic shower curtain, so you want one made out of cloth.
Yeah, some kind of cloth or something fire retardant. And, you know, of course, you'd have to be very careful, but interesting.
My question to you was, will this have... Because one of my clients also mentioned that her dad had bed sores and they can't get rid of it. Mm-hmm. So I thought to myself, well, buy one of these little lamps and, you know, that promote healing. He was in the hospital, they couldn't get rid of it. I remember when my sister was in the hospital, they couldn't get rid of her bed sore either. Mm-hmm. And they were pumping him full of antibiotics. And
right. Well, there you go. That's part of the problem.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, I can't speak to that specifically. I think the best things for bed sores is constant changing of position.
No doubt.
Complete.
I mean, and if you're bedridden, that's a tough thing.
How do you hear about these people that get bed sores? They're in a hospital for, you know, weeks or months. And I have a family member who took care of her daughter for 25 years who had MS and never got a bed sore. Does that attest to the family care of rotation? And they had lifts and pulleys to change her and constantly lift her. That's amazing. But there could be some susceptibility. But getting back to the saunas, this is a great tool, and you kind of surprised me on this one, but I do like the work of Dr. Larry Wilson. We also at Premier Research have done a lot of work into the power of infrared, near-infrared, far-infrared healing, and we have a product called the Earth Wrap.
Yes.
And what's neat about it is it was designed by PRL. It uses what Dr. Forbes has determined to be the most piezoelectric and most beneficial gemstone, which is pink granite. Interesting.
Yeah.
And guess where we find the pink granite?
Egypt.
In the King's Chamber of the Great Pyramid.
Really?
You would have to believe it must be very powerful. It has some very interesting explanations of being very beneficial for entering and exiting the world. Interesting.
Yeah.
Now, a little easier to use. You can buy them in a small mini size up to a small heating pad size to a full size in your bed. Get the power of it. I am addicted to it. I have it. I turn it on. I sleep with it.
Yeah.
Even in the summer, because it's like sleeping on the ground.
Yeah.
So it gives you that ability.
And I'll be putting this in the next newsletter coming up.
But it's an idea to learn about the power of these earth-yielded healing technologies, which we all need.
Number here is 877-927-6648. You have some time to pick up some Primal Edge. Take a look at my newsletter. Subscribe to that. It's only $5 a issue, $10 a month. We'll be right back.
You've heard Nico DeHaan as co-host of Living a Primal Lifestyle, which airs every Friday at noon Eastern Time on TFNN. And we'd like to tell you about the personal training studio that Nico is the owner and president of, Performance Training. Since 1998, Nico has trained individuals and groups to improve their health both mentally and physically. As a certified personal trainer, Nico's main focus is on demonstrating exercises correctly to avoid injury and teaching his clients how to manage their past injuries while getting the most out of their personal training sessions. The Performance Training Studio is filled with unique training equipment that enhances balanced results at a faster rate while minimizing damage and discomfort. For more information, you can give Nico a call at 727-418-8255.
8740 or email him at nico@tfnn.com. Let him know you heard him on TFNN and save up to $100 on a special package just for TFNN listeners. Act today. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
No matter where you listen to TFNN programming, we want you to know you can always access your favorite shows on demand through tfnn.com. TFNN airs live programming every market day from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. Eastern. And you can view each program by accessing Tiger TV through our homepage. We even have an easy link for all mobile devices, including iPhones and iPads, located at the top right-hand corner of the TFNN homepage. You can use your smartphone to view Tiger TV. But if you don't have a mobile connection that can keep up with streaming live video, then you can simply visit tfnn.mobi in the browser of your smartphone for live streaming audio of all of our programs. The mission of TFNN is to educate our audience directly and interactively through our interactive website and radio call and talk shows. TFNN is able to teach all levels of investors the technical skills needed to trade in today's marketplace. In order to get the best information possible, TFNN has assembled the most respected financial minds in the country to provide the most current news and comprehensive advice available. TFNN.com, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hey, and welcome back, Primal People. I'm Paige Clark, and Nico DeHaan and I are living Primal, and we want you to, too. You know, a school district outside of Seattle said they want to make sure when their kids go out that they move their bodies and give their brains a break. But you and I kind of feel like maybe they need, the district needs to give their brains a break. Listen to this.
Yeah, it's the Mercer Island School District, and school teams have recently revisited expectations for student behavior to address student safety. This means while at play, especially during recess and unstructured time, students are expected to keep their hands to themselves. The rational behind this is to ensure physical and emotional safety for all students. So they won't let them play tag, in other words.
Yeah, and you know, I don't know about you guys. Let me know. I mean, that is one of the things we looked forward to, is that running. And why are we trying to remove the element of human touch? You know, completely. What I see in so many schools, maybe they're going to say it's okay if you sit quietly and you can play on an iPad or something, or, you know, or just sit or sit and not interact. And it's just furthering that
non-interaction. Well, we're getting less and less interaction just because of our computers and all that stuff. And I saw another study that said the kids are getting these neck pains from because we're supposed to sit up nice and straight, and when we're looking at these machines all day long.
They call it, iPhone neck or something.
Something like that, yeah.
Smartphone neck.
We'll give Apple all the credit for that, I guess.
You know, actually, this article is interesting because they cited research that was done And it talked about Dutch children play about 90 different games, tags being one among them. And I thought, you're a Dutch guy.
I am a Dutch guy, and I play many games.
And you like to play. You like to play. That's what we've been talking about today.
That's what jiu-jitsu is all about, is playing and getting your hands on people. I don't understand. I mean, I understand where they're coming from, because they're looking at from a safety standpoint. But this goes against everything that human beings do.
Of what play really is. Once again, we have an age-old childhood tradition that is suddenly too dangerous for this generation. Yeah. What's happening? You know, what is happening? It's just so much intrusion of government or society into what is actually normal human behavior. How can it be that for 450 plus years since the beginning of time, kids played this very same game, but today's youngsters are too fragile?
So what is normal human behavior?
Yeah.
Well, I think it's
interaction. I think it's touch. It's interconnectedness. It's bonding on a physical, mental, spiritual, emotional level. Yes. It's namaste. It is, I see, my soul sees the divine soul in you. The divine soul in me sees the divine soul in you. We're connected.
We want to structure everything into a little box. That's the way we educate our kids. We don't let them freely go out and go with their passion. They discourage that passion. If you've got a passion that's a little bit out of the box, you're not going to go towards it, because you're going to be stopped along the way. I certainly felt that, and that was a whole different ball game, you know, 40 years ago, 50 years ago when I was in school, compared to today. We did a lot of things differently. We stressed going outside. We stressed having physical time. We stressed all these little games that we played, and most of them involved touching and running after each other, and even sometimes tackling each other and whatever it took. I remember some of my greatest moments as a kid, even into my early teens, was waiting before dinner. I'd go out 2 hours I want dinner as late as possible, Mom, because I want to play tag and hide and seek with all the
Red Rover,
exactly.
Send Pagey over, right over. and you know, because everything that I'm going through right now, you know, one of the big things that my father wanted, and again, one of those things that we should have, was he was a really big thing for him. He wanted to get our 8mm family movies converted and our slides, which we're going to do. Mm-hmm. But, you know, how many months and years had he actually been begging us to all do it? And
the best way to do that is gather it all up and have a professional do it. You'll spend a few $100. It's going to be worth it much better. And they'll actually look at it a little different, because there's a lot of companies now that will organize it for you by date, because all these things now have stamped with a date. But also, they'll group them into activities and everything for you, as long as you give them some kind of little instruction. So, you know, I would recommend that highly.
Yeah. I was thinking about, chasing the lightning bugs. Any of you guys ever do that? You know, when you chase them and you catch them with the jars and look at them at night.
Yeah.
We don't have those in Florida, but I remember it.
I think
jumping
some
in the
Florida
leaves.
Sometimes.
Jumping in the leaves in October.
Yes.
That's coming up.
I saw a little video on YouTube the other day where this dog was jumping into the leaves and going out of
it. I sent it to you.
Oh, yeah, you did send it to me. Yeah.
Yeah.
And this dog's running around the yard and he jumps in it again. I mean, just having fun.
Well, and it reminds me what you're always trying to coach us on, you know, play. You know, that shirt. I was trying to find that shirt, become an outsider, be an outsider. You know, and it has like that dual connotation of, to be outsider is kind of like something you don't want to be. You want to be an insider, but no, we want you to be an outsider.
Yeah, yeah.
And I saw that, and I thought, you know, that would really appeal to you.
And if you can mix your exercise with your play, that's a much more natural way of doing things. So, you know, folks, get outside, get into the green air, and breathe that beautiful air, and do some activity out there. Get there with your kids or your friends or your pets. And, you know, life just gets better when you do that, I think. And, you know, it's really hard these days, and I feel it myself, too. This week was a real stressful week. I didn't do as much jiu-jitsu as I wanted because I had too many things going on, and I just had to tell myself on Thursday, I said, you know, I just can't do jiu-jitsu today because I'm just too stressed. And I just took the afternoon and just really calmed myself down. And by 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I felt really good.
Yeah.
So sometimes you do have to listen to your body. And it's not just physical things that do it. It's the mental things. It's being on this structure where you have to be someplace every 15 minutes or every hour. And this is our life now. And I don't like it that way. No. I like when things just flow naturally, and I'm not bound by the clock so much. We never had clocks back in the old days, folks, and we were just going by what the sun was telling us and the moon and the stars.
Well, that's kind of what I do. You know how I am about a clock.
Yeah, well,
I mean, I'm
sometimes
not,
you stroll in here a little.
That's not my.
Well, we do things different. That's why we get along so well, because I'm here an hour early, mm-hmm. just making sure I'm ready. And that's what I've always done all my life. That's mm-hmm. the habit I got into, because my dad says, if you're 15 minutes early, you got time to relax.
Yeah.
It's a good time. And so I've always pushed it that I'm at least 15 minutes early.
But you know, when you say that about the time, I really think, you know, obviously you have to be respectful of other people's times, and you have to, you know, be there for what people are counting on you. But in terms of everyday life, I'm trying to embrace that a little bit more. Like, does it really matter, you know, if you change your mind, that spontaneity of saying, mm-hmm. it's beautiful, so let's stay out longer. So we're going to encourage you guys to find opportunities to play. Maybe some of you guys in the chat room let us know.
And spontaneity, you know. That reminds me of, in fact, I had gotten a divorce, and I was living in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and I just met this girl, and we were bouncing around, dated for about a few months, you know, and then we were driving by, and there's this whole big field out there. She says, stop the car, and I pull over, and she says, come on in the field, and we were running into the field, and we were running and feeling free, and all of a sudden, she started taking her clothes off and my clothes off, and there. We were making love right in the field. I had never done anything like that. I thought, oh, I'm going to hang around with this girl more often, you know. Not because of the sex so much, just because of the feeling, being out in the field naked. I hadn't really done that too much.
I've done that before.
I bet you have.
Yeah.
Well, you're a natural girl. That's
well,
why.
Well, you know, I stop and think about these things. I think that, you know, since when did natural become the alternative? I'm doing a talk, by the way, on that.
Yeah, and our producer says you can't do that these days. Yeah, you're probably going to get arrested.
Yeah.
Not only for being naked, but having sex.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I don't know.
It's a crazy world out there today.
I think it's someone that I want to have on the show that talks about the importance of growing your own food, and that really you and your partner, your wife, your husband, you should make love in your garden, because that sexual energy will
transfer to the plants.
Your food. Yeah, I think that's kind of interesting. We're going to have to research that a little bit.
I'll tell my wife tonight. Honey, you want to go in the garden?
Yeah. You know, it makes good sense.
Let me ask you a question. Did you watch anything with the Pope coming in and stuff like that?
Well, unfortunately, that was all, you know, the day.
Oh, that's right.
I was at my dad's house, and, you know, just going through some things and stuff, and I would listen to it, but not so much. Not so much. What are your thoughts about it?
Well, I just thought he was, you know, how well-spoken he was, first of all, and, mm-hmm. Of course, he just mesmerized a lot of people. There's no doubt. I think he's a talented individual. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, I don't pay too much attention to religion, because I think organized religion, the organization takes the spirituality out of it myself. So I'm not Catholic. My dad was Catholic, and he kind of divorced from that because of the treatment he was getting when he was young. So I don't really follow anything like that, but I thought it was interesting, and certainly
I know it was highly anticipated, and I tend to also look at some other views that, you know, I was a little suspect of it, but with what was going on with me personally, it just became not as so important. But I'm sure I can re-access the actual talk. I saw a lot of the masses and the services.
Yeah.
But
I wonder, are people making like money off of any of the ventures that they might connect to the Catholic Church, like in New York or in Washington? Were there vendors out there? I always wonder. I think.
I'm sure souvenirs for that.
Yeah, I had a good idea. I was telling Tom earlier. He says, "That's a funny idea." But remember the soap? Well, I don't know if you did or not. But you remember the soap on a rope?
Oh yeah.
I thought Pope on a rope. Yeah, you just a little
thing. Yeah,
exactly.
Cleanse.
He could be handing them out. You know.
Pope on a rope.
Pope on a rope. Yeah.
In the shower, cleanse yourself.
Yeah. And then you could have the ivory version where it's Jesus on the rope and it floats.
Oh, jeez.
I'm going off the deep end here, but that's the kind of things I think of.
No, I know, but that's
But fun. I thought it was really amazing, the individual. This is the first pope I thought of that spoke so well and really got your attention and talked about a lot of things that the pope never talked about before.
Nico, actually, that's very creative.
Boca on a rope?
Oh, sorry, Nico. Already available.
So. Is that right?
You see, maybe what you subliminally, you actually.
Well, I think, to be honest, I think years ago, I remember a skit on Saturday Night Live.
It's probably your subconscious remembers that now you want to, in your mind, you want to take credit for the idea. I do that.
No, but
you know what I mean? Your own mental mind wants to think you created it. I do that all the time with some of my little sniglets that I come up with.
No, there is a theory out that when one thing is created, it's instantly created somewhere else,
The 100th monkey.
Yes.
The 100th monkey thing that, you know, once you come up with an idea, the reason you came up with it is there's other monkeys thinking about it, too.
Yeah, it's like the invention of fire. You know, we had fire a long time ago before that, you know, we got because of electricity hit or something like that. And we carried it around. But when we learned how to make fire, I think everything changed. Yeah. I think it probably happened in different parts of the world around the same time. Because spiritually, we evolve that way. So when we ever go to the next level spiritually as human beings, if that's possible, then I think it would happen to the majority of people. And
Well, think about it. You know, what we know is that there are pyramid structures and sacred geometry symbols that are all over the world. It's different spots, yet there was no way for them to each know each other. So there was some form of communication, you know, as we've talked about. So I think you're exactly right. I think, the one mindness that we're all part of, these things come in and out, you know. But I do like your idea. That was good.
That was a cute thing.
Yeah, it was very cute.
I hope I didn't embarrass anybody.
It's just part of what we do. We kind of, you know, we have fun here.
Yeah.
There's an article, and we're going to probably not be able to get too far into it, but I want to introduce
the blood? You sent me that this morning.
Yeah, this was, we love Sayer G from Green Med Info, and he wrote a really great article as a contributing article to wakeupworld.com. An amazing discovery, plant blood enables your cells to capture sunlight energy. So I want to just introduce it, and we'll maybe highlight a little bit more after the break. But what, because it kind of goes, it's a little challenging to our belief of needing animal foods versus, plant foods and our ability to nutrify our bodies. But just as a highlight, what if conventional wisdom regarding our most fundamental energy requirements has been wrong all along, and we can directly harness all the energy we need from the sun when we consume plant blood? And what is plant blood? Well, we know plant blood is chlorophyll. Okay, human blood is hemoglobin. There's only one difference in the molecules. In the plant, the center has a magnesium
base
element.
Yeah.
The human blood has an iron base. So there's that slow difference. So we have to agree, plants are amazing. You know, they have no need to roam about hunting other creatures for food because they have been smart enough to figure out how to capture the energy from the sun directly with those little light harvesting molecules known as chlorophyll, or the plant's blood, a molecule incidentally that bears uncanny resemblance to the human blood because it's structurally identical to hemoglobin, with the exception of the magnesium atom at the center and the iron at the center of the red blood cell. So it really causes us to take pause and say, what if we were able to do that? Maybe we really do have that capability, and what can we do to improve that? A couple of the points I want to make about it is, there's a lot of people that believe we can get sustenance. So you've heard about breatharians or sun gazing from utilizing this light source of energy. But we're going to have to take a break here.
Yep.
And so give us a call, 877-927-6648.
And then we have Tom from Tampa. That'll be on the line after that.
He wants to talk to us about pacemakers. All right, Tom.
We'll be right back, folks. You know what's cool?
taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Catch Steve Rhodes as he teaches techniques on technical analysis using pattern recognition, celestial charting, Fibonacci, and other tools. The Trader's Edge, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. And Steve Rhodes said there on Amazon there is a Pullman rope. On the Telestrator here, I have a picture of it.
Gadgets for God.
So, yeah, but they also have other things. So I wasn't way off base. They have a little bobblehead.
A Pope.
They have beer. And they got a lot of, a thong. That's kind of disgusting.
Oh, yeah.
They got T-shirts, and they even have a game, a Pope game.
There you go.
I don't know what the goal is. Maybe to get to heaven, I guess. And they have all kinds of different things. So I guess I wasn't too far off base anyway.
Okay, so we've got Tom from Tampa on the line. Hi, Tom.
Hey, Tom, how are you doing today?
You guys good.
So tell us the news here. Your mom is among the very first to receive a wireless pacemaker?
Well, now here's what's going on. She had a minor heart attack back when she was around 70. She had another one back in November. And the cardiologist is saying, hey, you need a pacemaker. And she's being stubborn about it. She's like, I'm a vegetarian. Why should I need a pacemaker? Because the cardiologist is telling you need a pacemaker. You know, you got to. And I just wanted to get your take on them. I didn't know there was such a thing as a wireless pacemaker. That's news to me.
Yeah, of course, the technology is getting better and better, and they're not as restrictive as they used to be. I had several clients over the years that had pacemakers, and their heart rate would only go so high. But now I think things are changing, so the technology is definitely getting better. Wireless definitely is part of that whole thing.
I honestly can't tell you, Tom. I always like to have an answer for you that I know of, you know, what's an alternative to a pacemaker. It's one of those things that we always try and find out, but what caused the problem that a pacemaker was required. Kind of, you know, peeling the onion is the approach I like to take on things. You know, from a medical standpoint, you know, there's no alternative to a pacemaker accordingly. If your heartbeat, you know, if you have a slowed heartbeat, or if your heartbeat goes too fast, they're trying to get it in pace. Mm-hmm. But what I say is, what is the underlying cause of that? And we do know that mineral deficiencies are often at the heart of, no pun intended, you know, heartbeat irregularity. You know, what do you see in emergency medicine? The first things they give you are magnesium, or baking soda, or salt, right? Sodium. Yeah. So you got to start looking at how these electrolytes might be involved. As I mentioned with my father's situation, where I suspect that he was depleted by too much fluid pills, you know, that caused a lack of blood volume, creating a weak situation, low.
Well, but I think part of the thing is that, of course, the damage is already done, and she needs a pacemaker to keep that heart going. There's nothing else that can really guarantee that the heart is going to tick at whatever they want it to tick at.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
But, and it's none of the, I mean, these days, it's a relatively easy procedure to go through, and it's not that as much bother as it used to be. It's much smaller, and people seem to have a really good life after that. So, you know, I would encourage you to get the best one possible.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and of course, encourage her to do all those other lifestyle things, you know, that you know because you listen to our show regularly, you know?
Yeah, and I really do think that.
I do. You know, the avocados, the fats, and everything else, absolutely.
And I think your body has a great ability to repair itself, too.
You know, here's some key points, you know, that I just looked up. I know we just got a quick thing, but no caffeine. Watch your alcohol intake. Increase your beneficial fats. You know, healthy oils for the heart. Omega-3s, take extra nutrients, mineral supplementation, and consider some of the heart-proven efficacy of certain herbs for cardio-protective, which I can help you with if you want to. But those along with her pacemakers, doctors may say, hey, you're doing so well, you don't need it. But but have her do what her doctor wants her to do, and good, healthy lifestyle, and she'll be in good shape, Tom.
Thanks for calling, Tom. We really appreciate it.
Okay, thanks. You guys have a good weekend.
Yes,
yeah, thanks
too.
A lot. Yeah,
and the rest of you all have a great weekend.
Definitely, and we'll see you next week, and we'll have dig up some other information for you.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You're watching Tiger TV.